Sono io qui a questo, c'è un nome, mi sembra in esercizio, e non deve venire. So let me take you through the question first of all. We were given an area of integers of size n, and we have taken n5 for the instance, and the number we have to search for is k, that is 16. We basically have to find the position of the variables occurrence of k in the array. Now, in linear search, we compare the number to the search with the very first element, then with the second, third, fourth, and so on till the number is found or the array is completed. Now moving to the question, the coding part. Here we have taken a method under the class solution in which we have taken the arguments array arr, integer n, and k, where n is the size of the array and k is the number to be found. Under which we have declared the value of found to be 0 as we have not found the number yet. As soon as we found the number, we'll change the value of found accordingly, that is 1 or minus 1 or anything we want. And I've also taken the value of I to be 0 so that we don't have to declare it again and again for the for loop here or the if statements. Now we have taken a for loop in which I will iterate from 0 to n minus 1 and increasing the value by 1 for each iteration, in which I will iterate from the beginning to the end of the loop till all the arrays sorted or searched. Now we'll check if we have found the number or not, for which we have taken a if statement in which we'll check if k is equal to the number in the array at position I. And if it is, then we'll set the value of found to be 1, break through the loop and get out of the loop. And if it is not, then we'll run the loop again and again. Now moving on, after the loop is finished, we have found the number or not according to the situation. We'll check if found is equal to 1, that is we have found the number. And we'll return I plus 1, that is the index of where the number lies. Or else we'll return minus 1. The reason why we're returning I plus 1 is because here we've taken I is equal to 0 and we have to consider the very first position to be 1. But here we are considering it to be 0. So that is why we have to plus 1 so that it doesn't cause any happen something like that. And now when we run the code, we'll get the position if it is present there. Now it is present at position 4. That is 16. The number to be solved for 16, and it is present at position 4.